If we learned one thing over the weekend, it's that no one knows what a catch is. Even if you think you know what a catch is, you're probably wrong. The NFL's catch rule is one of the most confusing rules in all of sports, and it reared its ugly head again on Sunday during the Patriots-Steelers game. With just 28 seconds left to play in a game the Steelers were trailing 2,724, Ben Roethlisberger appeared to hit tight end Jesse James for a 10-yard touchdown that would have given the Steelers the lead. Instead, the call was overturned, even though most people thought it was pretty clear that James had caught it. Reggie Bush, who played in the NFL for 11 years, thought it was a touchdown. Terrible call by refs at the end of the Steelers game that was a catch. Reggie Bush at Reggie Bush, December 18, 2017. Former Colts coach Tony Dungy said that common sense pretty much says the Steelers scored. In flag football, high school football, college football, any place you play football other than the NFL, that's a touchdown. NBC's Tony Dungy on Steelers' Jesse James' TD catch being overturned. Chris Odamski at C_AdamsKatrib, December 18, 2017. Even some Patriots fans thought the catch should have stood. I never tweet in game. I love the Pats, but this is absurd. Steelers won this game. That was a catch. The NFL is absurd. Evan Cohen at Evco Radio, December 18, 2017. James also thought it was pretty clear that he caught the ball. However, only one opinion matters, and that's the opinion of the Alberto Riverin, the NFL's vice president of officiating. Since James was initially ruled to have scored a touchdown, the play was automatically reviewed by Riverin at the NFL's Replay Center in New York. Since the play was so controversial, Riverin felt the need to release a video and explain why James catch didn't count, and let's just say that Riverin might have just confused things even more. For one, Riverin opens up the video by mentioning that Roethlisberger completes a pass to James. As we can see, Roethlisberger completes a pass to James and James is going to the ground as he reached the goal line, and that's the key here, he is going to the ground, Riverin said. If you're trying to make a confusing rule less confusing, you probably should start by saying that Roethlisberger completed the pass, which implies that a catch was made, which means the Steelers scored. Riverin could have simply said that Big Ben threw a pass to James and then moved on. Anyway, that's our cue to move on to the rest of Riverin's explanation. By rule, to complete the process of the catch, he must survive the ground. And by that, we mean he must maintain control of the football, Riverin said. As we see on the play, James does put the ball over the goal line extended. Once he gets there, he loses control of the football and then the ball hits the ground. It doesn't matter that James ever had possession, because he didn't maintain control all the way to the ground. We can see here the ball touches the ground, so therefore two things occur: he loses control of the football, and the ball touches the ground prior to him regaining control, Riverin said. Therefore, the ruling on the field of the touchdown was changed to an incomplete pass. This is a call that's going to be debated for the rest of the season, especially because it could end up costing the Steelers home field advantage in the playoffs. Although the controversial call did go against the Steelers, they actually still had a chance to win or tie the game in the final seconds, but Roethlisberger threw an interception in the end zone that sealed the Patriots' win. If that pass had fallen incomplete, the Steelers would have had a chance to tie the game with a 25-yard field goal attempt. As for the catch rule controversy, you can see and hear Riverin's entire explanation below.